welcome you out to the first Potter's House Worcester online concert. Drop some likes on the chat, drop some comments. I want to see you say that you are here tonight. Listen, you are in for a good time. I don't know how you do things in your end, but right now, as part of the Potter's House, we're about to drop some tunes about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So we're going to roll it out right from the beginning. I hope you are ready. If you're not ready, stand up to your feet in your house and join me right now. DJ, roll the track. This song is called Through the Narrow Road. It's talking about bringing everyone of my friends with me. I don't want to go by myself when I reach heaven. I want all my friends to come with me. So listen to the words. Woo! Check, check.
Gotta set the laws, gotta set their soul. Ay. Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Gotta set the laws, gotta set their soul. Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road, ay. Through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. I said through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road. Through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. Listen, the end is near and you need to change your life for him. It's very clear, well, you end in a life of sin. Hell is the destination, it's the real thing. But Jesus can change all the pain and the suffering. He'll dash it in the bin, cleanse you of your sin. No more taking L's, victory's yours and you in. And it's hard to believe, but in him you'll receive salvation, restoration, mad love for the nation. Talk about revelation, no more hesitation. If you miss the ride, 7 years tribulation. And after that, judgment, internal damnation. So where you going, fam? It's your decision, like, hey, gotta set the laws, gotta set their soul. Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Gotta save the lost, gotta save their soul. Woo! Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road, through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. I said through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road, through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. I said heaven is our goal. Heaven is our home. Jesus on the throne and we'll never be alone. I said heaven is our goal. Heaven is our home. Jesus on the throne and we'll never be alone. Listen, if you there now, can you hear me? You can be distracted and choose to ignore me, but I know my Jesus is coming for me. You pretending you don't, but I know you want it low-key. I know you want it low-key. I know you want to be saved, G. I know you want Christ to change and make you all clean. He'll rapture the saints and we'll bow our knee. Blink now, miss me. Repent now, trust me. Like, hey, gotta save the lost, gotta save their soul. Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Gotta save the lost, gotta save their soul. Gotta bring the man them through the narrow road. Through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. I said through the narrow road, yeah. Through the narrow road. Through the narrow road. Heaven is our goal. I said heaven is our goal. Heaven is our home. Jesus on the throne and we'll never be alone. I said heaven is our goal. Heaven is our home. Jesus on the throne and we'll never be alone. Like, gotta save the lost, gotta save their soul. Yeah, 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 yeah. I gotta save the lost, gotta save their soul. Chase through the narrow road, hey, hey, through the narrow road, yeah, through the narrow road, hey, man, listen, that's through the narrow road. I hope you like that track. The next song that I'm gonna do for you is called Time Ain't Stopping, and you know what? Jesus one day is coming back. And, you know, our life is going to end. And you need to be ready because, you know, time ain't waiting for you to accept what he's got for you. So this is what the track is. Listen to it. And I want you to join with me on the chorus in your homes. It's simple. When I say time is stopping, you say pat, pat, pat. We're going to get there.
Exit made this.
Yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Time ain't stopping. Woo. My Jesus will be knocking. Pat, pat, pat. Satan trying to stop me. Yeah, but I know that God has got me. Yeah, my Jesus will be knocking. Bap, bap, bap. Satan trying to stop me. Yeah, but I know that God has got me. Listen, choice is yours, it's there for the taking. Food laid out on the plate for your tasting. Nah, trust me when I say it's frustrating. I'ma tell you bad truths, but you're still not celebrating. Like, you live life with no motive, bro. Babe, by Friday, but Monday you are out of dough. Cuz you spend it all on the week. Can't pay your bills, but you still gotta pretend. Right? Nah, 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 forget all that. Jesus came so I don't have to fall back. He keeps
my life on track. He sets my goals, I just aim, he brings the bow and zip, he brings the draw back. Hey, he brings the draw back. Hey, he keeps my life on track. He keeps my life on track. He sets my goals, I just aim, he brings the bow and zip, he does the draw back. Yeah, time ain't stopping. My Jesus will be knocking. Back. Hey, Satan trying to stop me. Yeah, but I know that God has got me. Time ain't stopping. Hey, my Jesus will be knocking. Back. Satan trying to stop me. Yeah, but I know that God has got me. Satan in the most high. Jesus is the most high. He's the one that won't die. Original nice guy. Bear grace, bear favor, just drop. Bear all purposes and in on that chicken thigh. Woo! I just compare myself to a chicken thigh. Why? Cause I was that raw. But trust me when I say I'm no longer that guy. I'm not the same dude as before. Cause I chose right. Yeah, I chose cry. Jeez. I chose right. Yeah, I chose cry. Yeah, I chose right. Sing it. I chose cry, yeah. And I chose right. I chose cry, hey. Time ain't stopping, hey. Time ain't stopping. My Jesus will be knocking. Back. Satan trying to stop me, yeah. But I know that God has got me. Time ain't stopping. My Jesus will be knocking. Back. Satan trying to stop me, yeah. But I know that God has got me. I know that God has got me. I know that God has got me. Jeez, track done. Listen, time ain't stopping. DJ, roll the next one straight away. The theme of this concert, I hope you understand, is that Jesus is coming back. And there's no lie about this. And I'm going to tell you a bit more why I believe this so fully. But right now, listen to this song. This song is called Jesus is Coming Back. And I hope you hear the words. Cheer, listen. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back, hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo-hoo-hoo. Jesus is coming back, hey, Jesus is coming, coming back, hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo-hoo. Hey, reload the track, DJ, reload the track up in here, let the DJ roll out the track. And listen, I don't know if you're ready for this one. Let me reload it so you can hear exactly what I'm going to hear. Yeah, you got the chorus now, I want you to sing it with me on the next one. We got that, DJ? Listen, yeah, Jesus is coming back. Let's go. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo-hoo-hoo. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo! Let me tell you about the Savior of the world. Jesus Christ came, died on the cross for your soul. Died in control. Died on his own. Could have called legions down, but he said no. He said not yet. Ready, set, go. Took upon pain and stripes to change you, though. So I tell you this message of facts. Guess what? Jesus is coming back. Who is it, Jesus? Right, heard before, but never really met the guy. Like, hey, did he even really die? Oh, are you telling me a blatant lie, fam? Are you listening? God's own son took it all on the chin, took it all in while innocent to sin, to save you from pain and the suffering. Cause that is the price that he paid. The lamb, his body, he laid. One day we all coming back, back. 1,000 years, we gonna reign. Ah, that is the price that he paid. The lamb, his body, he laid. One day we all coming back. 1,000 years, we gonna reign. Woo-hoo. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo-hoo. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Listen, when it comes like a thief in the night and you close your eyes and get caught by surprise. Poof, gone. Where they at though? You believe the hype, but now where you at, bro? You got left behind. Even believe that you had bad time. Said you'd do it later, but now your time's up. Why did you do it? Cause you made your mind up. But Lord, I was watching Stranger Things. Now you will witness Stranger Things. Winter is coming, season end. Sitting on a throne, but it ain't no game. Shame, now you're gonna be on your drums. Jack, you can still get your life on track. I told you this message of facts. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Yeah, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming. Coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. So, whose side are you on? Make a decision by the end of this song. Whose side are you on? Choose life, choose right or choose wrong. Whose side are you on? You moving with Satan, you're moving along. Cause what side am I on? I chose Jesus, but a house we strong. Hey, hey, whose side are you on? Make a decision by the end of this song. Whose side are you on? Choose life, choose right or choose wrong. Whose side are you on? You're moving with Satan, you're moving along. Cause what side am I on? I chose Jesus, but a house we strong. Hey, hey, Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is, come on, let me hear you in the comments. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo, 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 Jesus is coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming, coming back. Hey, Jesus is coming back. Woo. Hey, I'm going home. Hey, I'm going home. Hey, I'm going home. Hey, heaven is my home. Sing it, I'm going.
Done. Listen, I hope you get the gist of what we say. I swear I take a few moments of your time and tell you a bit about myself. My name is Philippe. You know, I'm part of this fellowship that you are now tuning into, the Potter's House. And you know what? We believe that Jesus is Lord here. But it wasn't always like that. So, you know, when I was very young, my mom split up from my dad. You know, I was about 2 years old. And, you know, I was sent to live with my uncle. And that was my life. I lived with my uncle for 10 years. My uncle loved me. Great guy. And raised me quite in a loving home. But, you know, when I became 12 years old, I began to miss my family. Daily, I missed my family. And I wanted to be with my mom and my brothers and sisters. My mom just had a problem that she was dealing with because my dad left. And all of this was a lot that she was dealing with. So, she, you know, she became an alcoholic. And struggled with a lot of things for years. And then someone came and told her, you know, about Jesus Christ. And she accepted him. And from then on, her life began to change. She began to take steps and leave the alcohol behind and all these different things. And then she made the decision to come to the UK. She grabbed all of my siblings and she came to the UK. And what happened then is that, you know, my mom contacted me and let me know that she was here. And I wanted to be with my family so desperately that I came to the UK to live with my family. I came to live with my siblings, and it was something new to me. It was 10 years that I hadn't spent with my family. And then after that, what began to happen is that I realized I've got no father figure in my life, and it became to make me an angry young guy. I was always angry, and I was dealing with some emotions that I didn't understand at the time, you know, just feeling lonely and isolated, and I couldn't voice this out to anyone. And, you know, I'd see my brother get involved with the wrong people. And, you know, even myself having the tendencies and going out and becoming to get involved in the wrong crowd, it was only leading a certain way. And, you know, being from a single parent home, growing up in Northwest London, it was only leading one way. But then, you know, this guy came and, you know, I went to this dance classes because street dance at that time was popping, you know, everyone was watching this movie about street dance. So then I went and I wanted to get involved just to see, you know, what it was about. And I got involved in it and I became part of that group. And then the guy invited me to church. And I said to him, you know what? I'm not really into this God thing. Because I knew a bit about God. You know, my uncle was always, he was a Catholic, he was always in church. And I knew about God, but I was like, it's not really for me. Like, you know, you guys keep doing your thing, but that's it for me. So, but I kept going to the dance thing and I kept being involved. But this guy that was inviting me, he loved me as a bro. And he kept loving me as a brother. And I noticed that. And because of how he was towards me and, you know, the people that were around me, I eventually said, you know what? I'll come to this church thing. I'm going to come to church and see what it's about. And I came. And it was like a summer camp thing. And I remember the guy that was telling people about Jesus at that time, he said, you know, some of you need to pray. You need to let go of all these different things. And I remember I prayed for the first time and just wept. Like, I had so many tears just coming down my face, and so much so that I sat down and I had to hide it. I had to hide my face when we were in this, and only because I was moved and you know, I felt like God was really speaking to me and touching my life then. And then, you know, I came away from that and some of my friends just didn't recognize me. I wasn't the same guy. I had a fire for God. I was, you know, I wanted to live for God. I wanted to do things differently. And since then, the journey became that, you know, I was learning more and more about who God was. made some mistakes along the way, but God was helping me in this journey, you know. And I went from a guy that was sleeping around, was angry, aggressive, to becoming now, you know, I'm a married man, I've got a 5-year-old son. And, you know, this would have never happened. This was never going to be my future. But with God, this became my future and this became my reality. And now I'm living out that reality. And you know what? God has got so much more for me. And some of you, you know what? You're in the same boat. You went through some stuff and or you're going through some stuff. You are lonely. You are isolated. You are angry, but you can't speak to no one about it. But you know what? Jesus is here. And if Jesus comes into your life, I'm telling you, he can break that. And he can put you around the right people that will help you. And you will see your life will change. And once your life is changed, man, you're going to want to tell everyone about Jesus. The same way I'm telling you now, you are going to want to do the same. Because, you know, I just feel like, God, man, you just done so much for me. And it's the same thing that he can do for you today. Amen. But that's my testimony. I hope it resonated with some of you. Before I go, I'm going to do one more track. A bit slower than the ones that I just done now. This song is called Increase in Me. It's the stage that I'm at. You know, God, I want you to increase in me and I want to become more like how you are, how Jesus is. I want to be more like that. So please listen to the words in this song and just understand what we are saying here. This is a lo-fi type beat. And this is what we do. Listen. Issues. Let me talk about them. Yeah, grab a tissue in case I touch your heart, fam. Cause it's all about the heart, man. You don't need to accept, but I'm telling you your heart can't. Let me start with the responsibility of the church to go out there and search for all of those who hurt him, all of those who crying, all of those denying God. It's terrifying, the delusions of this world. Oh Lord, Christians wake up. This is a cold war, man. We need to raise up. So we're orderly things, flying with sin. Dash it in the bin, be a soldier, man. You need to raise up. That's right, you need to raise up. Stop wasting time, you need to raise up. Go save those souls, you need to raise up. And save those. Lord, I pray, increase in me. Jesus, increase in me. Lord, increase in me. Yeah, increase in me. Lord, I pray, increase in me. Jesus, increase in me. Lord, increase in me. Yeah. Increase in me, increase in me. Increase in me. Listen. Yo, round two, a second issue, let's go. You're an example. People don't know God's love, but know that you're a sample. Like, you've been saved from the circle of sin. So when they see you or circle you in, like I heard once, do people say you're a Christian because of your actions? Or do people think you're a Christian because of your acting? Oh, did I go too far? Did I leave a scar? I didn't mean to offend you, bro, but if the shoe fits, let it be so. Or you can raise up and let the shoe go. Stop watching sin and let the shoe go. And stop gossiping. Lord, I pray, increase in me. Jesus, increase in me. Lord, increase in me. Yeah, increase in me. Lord, I pray, increase in me. Jesus, increase in me. Lord, increase in me. Yeah, increase in me, increase in me. Call up to the stage now a different person. This is my wife. You're going to meet her in a moment. So I hope that you are paying attention to the concert so far and you are enjoying it. Please leave some comments. Let me know how you're finding it so far. Make some noise for your area. Let me know where you are. And, you know, I'm going to call Fedji up to the stage. She's going to walk up now. Just give it a moment.
Hello everyone, thank you for coming, good to have you here. I'm Feiji, as my husband already introduced. And I'm going to sing a few songs for you. The first song I'm going to sing is about Jesus coming back, which is kind of what my husband just sang about. But enjoy the songs. Oh. I call on his name. There is power there. Yeah, there's power there. Coming, 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 second coming, 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 second coming, second coming. There is no time for playing games. Time shorter today than yesterday. If you knew the way to eternity, would you keep it or share it with me? Coming, 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 second coming. To the next song. Enjoy. And listen to the words, guys. I hope you enjoy the song. It's about how Jesus saves. He is our Lord and King. He's risen from the dead and he's alive. Enjoy the song. Christ is risen and his spirit lives inside of me. Yeah. He's moving, working, changing, shaping, molding, healing. Woo. You know God's got a plan for you. He wants to help you out of the mess you're in. God can bring you out of your sin. His cleansing mighty power working for all of our good. Come to God and repent of all the dirty mess. He'll cleanse it, wipe it, clean it, shine, like new. unreal goals and standards that you're trying to fulfill yourself, you can claim a brand new life in God when you choose Him. You can have something desirable, and the Bible tells it all. You can have, you can have Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ. You know, the Bible says that when you choose God, you repent, you turn away from sin, your life becomes like new, you're a new creation. God cleanses your sin, and you can start from a clean slate, a brand new page. Amen. So, I'm going to give you my testimony now. You just heard Philippe's testimony. So I was raised with three sisters. So there's four of us, including myself and my mum. So our dad wasn't around. He was like in our lives, kind of, but he wasn't really like there. He was very estranged. Like he would sometimes, like he would say he would come and then he wouldn't come. So I didn't really know my dad very well. I didn't know him, but I knew his face and he was there, kind of. And growing up without a dad as a girl, I guess, well, some people I guess can really be aware of themselves, but me, I didn't realise that I needed a dad until later on in life. So at the time, I was lost and I was and my mum loved us, and my mum was a great woman, and my sisters, like, we all loved each other, but there's something missing when you don't have a dad, a father in your life. There is something missing, and I didn't realise that at that stage when I was growing up. And so, which resulted in all the things that I'd done. So, like, when I was older, I had a few relationships with guys, but I wasn't really, like, out, like, you know, guy to guy to guy. But I had a couple of relationships with guys, but one of the things that I really did that helped me to see that, you know, I was missing something in my life, the father figure. I worked as an escort and in gentlemen's clubs and stuff like that, and just looking, I guess you're looking for love, you're looking for something, for that kind of relationship with a guy. And it wasn't until when I became a Christian, I repented and I became a Christian when I was about 21, because I grew up in church, my mum was a Christian. And at the age of 18, she said that we could decide if we wanted to continue coming to church or not. I kept going because I kind of felt like, you know, why not? You know, I kind of know the church. So I kept going. And then I was in a relationship with this guy. And then we broke up. And so I went away with the church that I grew up in to this, like, Christian camp. It was like they do camping in tents and stuff. So we went away to that. I wouldn't have gone if I was still with the guy, because it was a whole week and I was like, I don't want to be away from my boyfriend. But then obviously we broke up, so I went. And it was there that I repented, and, you know, I decided to follow God. And you know, if you're maybe a backslider, if you kind of know about growing up in church, sometimes when you decide to follow God, life kind of gets in the way, if you know what I mean. And so you say, yes, I'm going to be a Christian, but then you kind of just continue about what you were doing before, which is what I did. I was about 20, 21, as I said. And so I repented. So, like, I had the jobs in the clubs and stuff. Repented, and then I still kind of, like, carried on with the clubbing life and all the stuff that you kind of do, you know, when you're not saved, and drinking and all that kind of stuff, and just living my life and enjoying myself. And but when I went to this Christian camp thing, the guy was saying, you know, you need to repent, you need to confess God as your Lord and Savior. And actually what he was talking about during his sermon was talking about speaking in tongues. And so I also wanted to be able to speak in tongues. So that I remember going up, and I was with my younger sister, and we went up together, and we kind of felt like we were speaking in tongues, but we weren't really sure. But obviously I wasn't really saved as well, so I didn't really know what it was about. And so it wasn't until after I got married up to my husband, Philippe. You've met him already. And when we moved to Birmingham, we're in the city of Birmingham at the moment. And when I joined this church, it wasn't until then that I realised that, well, in the past, people had preached about, you know, father this, father that. And I thought, oh, you know, God's your heavenly father if you haven't grown up with a dad. And I thought, I haven't grown up with a dad, God's my heavenly father, but what does that kind of mean? Because he's not here. That's what I felt like. And it wasn't until now, when I've come to learn more about God, about what his word says, about what the Bible says, that actually now I can say that I have a relationship with God. I pray more and I commune with God. I speak to God. And I feel like now I've got a relationship with God. And I feel like if there's anyone that feels, you know, I haven't grown up with a dad, or, you know, there's something that's missing, or you feel like you want a father figure, God, your heavenly father, really can be your father. And I know it kind of sounds a bit like, okay, because that's what I thought when people would preach about stuff like that. But it's, you can only understand that when you have that relationship with God. And I would encourage you, if you're listening and you're like, yeah, I haven't got a dad, or I would love to have a father figure, just come to God. Like, I don't know how to say it other than come to God. He can be your father. He is your father. And if you accept God into your life, and receive what Jesus did for you on the cross, and you confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you want God to be your heavenly father, he can be your father. I can't explain how it feels. You can only experience it. So I would say, for anyone out there that's listening that kind of can relate, don't hesitate. Repent, make God your heavenly father. Receive it. You have to receive it to know what I'm saying. Amen. We're going to sing some more songs. I hope you enjoy this one. Listen to the words, guys. It's about Jesus, our Lord and Savior, and how I love to worship him. They say God's faking that he doesn't exist. I know he's real because of the things he's done for me. They say I'm crazy to believe in that. I think you're crazy if you don't, in fact. They say that faith is for those who are weak. I say it's for those who are steady. They like to party while I'm in the house of the Lord. I enjoy worship, but they're saying there's a flaw. When you walk with Jesus, you can battle every storm if you do. Do you want to? Do you? Do you want to? Do you? You think you know yourself, but Jesus knows you more. Maybe no one's told you this ever before. Jesus is a savior, he died to save you. You have life or death when the payment is due. He's so compassionate and also powerful, and he's good and merciful. No one can compare to him. You're searching, you're looking for something new, and he's calling to you, to you.
Why? Because his light shines through me bright. I gave my life to Christ.
the kingdom of God once we follow the King and confess Christ and turn away from sin. And I know that my God breathes life, yeah, He breathes. Jesus is the truth, yes, He is so real. And I tell you now, before Him I will kneel. I know I'm made in the image of Him. And I can tell you why, because His light shines through me bright.
Where we are today is only because of God's grace. And you know what? His grace is enough that no matter where you are, no matter where your life is at, His grace can cover you and He can take you to a new place. You know, I was in a place where I was lonely, isolated, angry, frustrated with the world. I would look at my friends and think to myself, man, you've got a dad. At least you've got a dad. When they used to complain, at least you've got a dad. But then, you know, looking back, that was a massive hole in my life that couldn't be filled. I tried many different things. I slept around. I was fighting. I was doing all these different things. And nothing helped. But then God showed me grace. He opened up a door. He gave me an opportunity to be saved. That if I would pray, if I would repent of my sins, I could have a life with Him. And at first, I couldn't understand this. I couldn't understand, you know, what am I repenting of? But then I look back at my life, and even in the short period of time that I was, I have done so much wrong. And there is so much wrong all around me. And God is saying, you know what? You don't have to live like that. And the same grace that He showed me, He's showing you right now, this moment, where you are, in your home, on your phone, on your laptop, on your computer. God is saying, you don't have to continue that way. You know, the Bible says, for everyone has sinned and falls short of the glory of God. But God also says that he who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That if you repent and turn away from your sins, God can come into your heart and He can change you. And all the things that you've gone through up until this moment will be but a testimony of what God has brought you from. And life with God is so much more fulfilling. You know, you can go around the world searching for a million and one things. Money, fame, relationships, drugs, addictions, all of these things. You're going to pour yourself out into them. And the reality is, none of these are going to fulfill you. And you will forever be searching. And that's not what we are. The reason why there's a void, there's something that needs to be filled in your life. why no matter how high you achieve in your career, no matter how successful you are, the reason why that never fulfills you is because you were created to be in connection with God. But God is knocking on your door this moment. And I want to give you a chance, the same chance that was given to me, to pray and to repent of my sins, to turn away from all the wrong that I was doing. I want to give you the same opportunity, that if you would pray this prayer and invite God into your life, He would change you. Because you know, when we pass from this life, we either go to heaven or we go to hell. But that decision is made today. Whether you choose not to, or you choose to pray. So if you're there, and you once knew God, or you never knew God, you don't know about God, you don't know about Jesus, listen. I want to give you this opportunity, this moment. If you would pray this prayer with me, this moment, just repeat with me where you are in your space. Just say, Father God, I know that I am a sinner. And I know that Jesus Christ has died for my sins so that I could have eternal life. God, I want to connect with you today. I want to reconnect. I want to have that bond with you, God. Help me in my life, on this journey, to follow your steps. As I turn away from my sins, lead me to where you are calling me to be. I commit my life into your hands, in Jesus' name. Amen. It's only by grace that your life can be changed, and God can change that. I thank you. I want to thank everyone that came out to this conference and everyone that's here at the end. We had a great time doing this for you guys at Worcester. And my prayer is that many of you are going to come to the church opening tomorrow. Tomorrow, 11 a.m. Okay, I'm going to leave the details on the screen of where the church is going to be at the Methodist Hall. And listen, this is the grand opening of a new opportunity that you can come together with a pastor and connect with him. And your life can be changed if you would submit your life to God. Come to church tomorrow, 11 a.m. Don't miss it. There's contact details. If you've got questions, please, drop a comment on the comment section, on the live chat, anything. Let us know where you are. If you've prayed, I want you to text PRAY to the number that's appearing below right now. Text PRAY or give us a call, and we will be happy to have a conversation with you and hear what God has done in your life or what He can do in your life. And it's been my pleasure to do this. My wife, she's behind the scene right now, but she's very grateful for this opportunity. And I hope that you all are blessed by this concert. And we'll surely see you soon. Come to church, and we are going to see you soon. Thank you very much. I just want to close this off in prayer. Father, I thank you for everyone that came and watched this today. And I'm asking you, God, that you touch their hearts, touch their lives, and bring them to the place, God, where they can know you and have a relationship with you. Pour out your spirit into Worcester, God, and cause this city to rise up and become, God, a city that is chasing up for your kingdom, part of your kingdom, God. I'm asking you, Lord, that you start something wonderful in this city, God. Pour out your spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you and have a good night.